Hey guys, you here, right here, you know, welcome to episode 25 of our GTA 5 car showcase mini series. In this particular episode, we're going to be taking a look at the Rolls Royce, as we know in real life, but in the game it's called the Super Diamond Sports. I'm not too sure why it's called the Sports, because it's a luxurious pimp car that cost me $250,000 from the website of standrewsautos.com in the luxury section. So it's a four-door, similar features to the Bentley with the weight and the structure of the car. But other than that, you know, not sure why it's called a sport. Probably because of the speed or probably the performance-wise, I'm not sure, but we'll see. Let's rev this shit up first. Sounds smooth, sounds nice, yep. That's how it's supposed to sound. Let's go through this gap here. Alright, let's give this a little test drive before we go and customize this. So I bought this from the website, by the way. In case you're wondering, you can find these on the streets, but it's very uncommon. Similar case to the coil within the game, which, you know, takes time to find as well. You can find this in the richer areas like the Rockford Hills, probably. I've seen a couple around a few days ago, but ever since I haven't really seen one, so I decided to buy this from the website as it was available from there. Ooh, you can drift with this car. That's pretty nice. Handling seems a bit weird right now. It is pretty responsive when you're turning with analog stick, as you can see. I'm doing it purposely right now. But, yeah, it's, as I said, awful lot similar to the Bentley. Although the Bentley's slightly bigger on the backside of this car looks a bit weird. I don't really like it. Look at that, the slouching, lazy, fat shit. But from the front looks nice, man. As we all know, Rolls Royce, them expensive cars. I'm too afraid to drive this really fast. Like, the handling's a bit dodgy at times, especially when you're going at high speed because of the weight it takes you off road as you're braking. The braking sucks as well, by the way. Check this out. See, I'm braking now, right? And it stops all the way at the end of the road. Sometimes I feel like I'm having to use the handbrake too much. Let's go through this alley here. But I'm loving the rev sign, though. Sudden turn here, so the turning sucks as well. It's tight corners. But what the fuck is fucked up, bro? See, when you drive around this game, right, you can just hear some people, you hear these voices and people talking, but you can't really see where they're talking from. I just clipped the freaking pole there. What's this? This is a pretty nice road. I believe this is like one of the first missions you do with the car. You go here. Oh, snap, bit of aerial. Oh, I like that. That is nice. Let's go from here. You know what, let's take the car for a wash. There's nothing much to say about this car, to be honest. You know, it's just this casual four-door cars that I'm not too sure why exactly it's a sport. It is pretty fast though for this car. How's this work? Alright, there we go. $15 to wash your car. I guess it's supposed to make sense, but look at that. Yes. Looking nice and luxurious. Snipping his fingers because he loves that coke. Alright. Should be good. How's it looking? Looking fresh? That looks nice. Yes. Cars can get dirty in this game, by the way, if you go off-road. That's probably why they have that there. Otherwise, it wouldn't make sense. Right, where's the customizing shop? Should be near one. Close one, that one. Let's go, look at that. You can see the wheel. Interior looks really nice. Let's do this. Top speed wise, not too sure. Definitely the response time for an accelerating is really, really slow as well. Everything to do with the weight of the car. Just to the right here. Drift the shit. Was not too bad, actually. Dude, why are you stopping, man? Oh, there's a motorbike there. We had a motorbike one of the episodes. Okay, that's awkward. That's such an awkward time. God, man, fat shit. Listen to that sound. Right, see what we got available for this car.
What miracle did you want me to perform?
Armor, 25 grand, wow. This actually costs the same as the freaking upgrading the cheaters and stuff. Alright. And you know what, the white one suits it. Respray. Classical colours. Much better on this. What we got for this? What kind of colours we got available for this? Wine red. pink. Serious right now. Slow down. Midnight blue. Or this blue. Galaxy blue. Saxon blue. So it's got to suit the interior. Marine blue. These colors look disgusting, man. Diamond blue. Here we go. Alright. Suspension. Transmission. Turbo. Wheels, bulletproof tires, blue smoke, wheel type. It's a high-end car. Damn. Oh shit. Nah, that don't suit that. What we got? Some of this, this and that, this and that. Yeah.
If that car was a woman, I'd guess her.
Indeed you would. Frost white definitely suits that. Windows, nice. That's pretty much it. So no exterior upgrades for this car. I'm liking this. Could be used for our weddings and stuff. Let's wrap this shit up. Oh wow. Okay, I think the blue smoke on the tires kind of killed it though, still. That definitely doesn't suit this car. But anyway, let's just go with the flow for now. Test out the accelerating on this. Definitely quicker gear change, as expected, as always. This is actually pretty fast. Holy shit, I wasn't expecting this performance. Definitely a huge, huge change. Definitely feel that. Visual aspect as well. That sounds real good. Did I just click that car, really? Drift that. No way! That's insane! Yo, man! It's looking good. Test out the sharp turns. This ain't a sharp turn, but... Ooh, that was close. Had to make up a quick... Make up my mind real quick there. Sharp turn, it kind of sucks. Took that long to turn. Another one here. It's alright. The only way you can turn is to completely let go of the acceleration. You can't really turn and accelerate at the same time. Ooh, quick brake and responsive there. Weaving it out. Yeah, that sucks. That completely sucks. Alright, well, that's pretty much it for this car, you know. I wanna test out how fast it can really go. A straight road, let's go. I'm not gonna stop now. This actually looks really nice with the tinted out windows for this. Really liking that. There we go. Come on. Oh my goodness me, don't do that, don't turn into my car. Let's go, let's go. Ooh, that was close. Near miss. I'm liking this. Come on, next gear, come on, next gear, next gear, next gear. Change the gear, change the gear. It's not how fast it goes. Oh, there we go. Wow! What? Did you guys see that? I just took out an SUV with this car and a tire bus up as well. Up to the person inside, he's dead. Got knocked the fuck out. That's insane. That's how powerful this armor is for this car, by the way. You guys saw that impact. Literally, right, the tire's over there, right behind the car. You see that tire there? Middle of the street? This dude went flying with his SUV. That's a Range Rover. We're talking about a Range Rover. Is that supposed to be good as well? Like, it's supposed to be strong with its armor and stuff. Oh my god, look at that. He's dead. Let's just wake him up. Hello? I think he's dead now. But yeah, he was already dead, but... Shit! Well, so say goodbye to you. Oh shit. Let's run that. Oh crap. I think I blew up my car. Oh no. Oh no. Oh shit. It looks like a pile of shit now. Look at that. This is like a pink panther. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'll see you guys soon. Feel free to leave a like and let me know what you guys think of the upgrade for the car as well. Performance wise, it's much faster than the Bentley after upgrading the performance and customizing the maximum potential. But other than that, pretty awesome car. The handling's a bit dodgy when it comes to sharp turning, but really fast when it comes to straight roads. But I don't know why I'm running right now. Oh yeah, police, right? Okay. But yeah, definitely a strong car. Let me bomb for the police. Ooh. Anyway, check your son out, nappies. Yeah!